A normal female is born with three perineal orifices, urethra, vagina, and the anus. When a baby is born with a cloaca, the urethra, vagina, and the rectum are fused together as a common channel that opens as a single perineal orifice. The length of this common channel may vary, and it has important significance to what we call the spectrum of cloacal anomalies. In the most benign side of the spectrum, we have patients with a short common channel length, less than 3 centimeters, normal sacrum, and these patients can be repaired posterior sagittally without having to open the abdomen. We separate the rectum from the urogenital tract, and then we perform a maneuver called total urogenital mobilization when we bring down together urethra and vagina. These patients, most of them have bowel control, urinary control, normal sexual and reproductive function, provided they received a technically correct operation. In the most severe side of the spectrum, we have patients with a very long common channel, more than 5 centimeters in length, in which, in order to repair them, we need to open the abdomen and we follow a very detailed decision-making surgical algorithm based on the type of anatomy that we find. For example, 60% of our patients with cloaca have duplicated Müllerian structures. That means that they have 2 hemivaginas and 2 hemiuteri. And sometimes these big vaginas are very high in the abdomen and we are not able to bring them down. So the longitudinal distance between the hemivaginas is greater than the vertical one that we need to travel to reach the perineum. So for that specific anatomy, sometimes we can do a maneuver called vaginal switch, when we will sacrifice one hemiuteri and just switch one vagina down. In other cases, we have a very small vagina high in the abdomen, and we need a partial vaginal replacement to bridge this gap. Depending on the future prognosis for bowel control, we can select what's the best tissue to use as the partial vaginal replacement, rectum, colon, or small bowel. As in most cases of anorectal malformation, the operation is just a small portion of their care. It is the long-term follow-up that will assist them to have the best possible quality of life.